Hi, this is Gary with MACMOST.com. MACMOST is brought to you by the more than 300 people who contribute to the MACMOST Patreon campaign. Find out how you can become a part of it at MACMOST.com/Patreon. So let's take a look at mail and using mail templates. Now, before macOS Mojave, you had the ability to have stationery, and there were all these preset stationery templates that you could use, and you can create your own. The problem with stationery was that they really didn't look good on mobile devices, and you really couldn't count on them looking good on non-Mac devices anyway. So it was really a bad idea to use complex layouts like in stationery. With more than half the people now reading their email on mobile devices, you want to keep things simple. But suppose you do need some basic template functionality, like you send out the same email every month with just a few changes. You can still create templates, and I'll show you how to do it. So I'm using Mac Mail here, and I'm going to create a new email message, and I'm going to leave everything blank here at the top, but I'm going to add a subject, and then I'm going to add some body text here. And I'm going to add a little flourish to it, some styling and things like that. So you can see here I've done a few things. I've colored some text. I've changed a font here and there. I've put an image in there. You can easily use the tools at the top here to make some changes. Change a font size, make it bold, you know, even change the color if you want. And you can even justify things, so I can center that text there. So now that I've got that, I'm going to close this window, and it's going to say, do you want to save this message as a draft? So I'm not going to send it to anybody. I'm going to save it as a draft and hit save. So a draft is an email that you can get back to later to complete it. If I go into my drafts folder, there it is. And I can actually double click on it. Now fill out the rest here, like who this is going to, and then send it. But I'm not going to do that here. Instead, I'm going to create a new mailbox. I'm going to click here, create a new mailbox. I'm going to create it on iCloud since I'm using iCloud for all my email. It should work no matter where you create the mailbox, but iCloud will be nice because it will be available on my MacBook as well as my desktop Mac. And I'm going to call it stationery. And now that I've created this new folder here, I am going to drag this message to stationery. So it's going to go out of drafts into stationery. Now that it's there, I can select it, and if I actually double click it, I could read it, but I can't edit it. So in order to send it, what I want to do is with it selected, I can go to message and send again. Notice there's even a keyboard shortcut for it. Now I get this message into a new email message here, and I could fill out who it's to. I can then fill in the spaces down here, date, location, topic that I had, or maybe you don't even have any of those. And you can see everything else is there, and I could send that email, and I still have the main copy of it here in stationery. So I can add a few of these here in stationery, select the one I want, send again, and then send it out. So that's a really easy way to create these templates that you can reuse in mail. Now, it was kind of limiting on, you know, what I could do here with this, you know, the tools inside of mail. Just these basic formatting things here. But you can actually do more. Mail can handle more than that. Matter of fact, I've created this message here in Pages, and I have a text box here, and I've filled it in. It's actually a shape here, and I filled that in. I actually, you know, I put that image here. I put a table in there. You could add other things like, I could add more shapes. I can add more images, you know, and put them there. So I just put, for instance, that shape there. The key thing is under Arrange, you need to set Text Wrap to inline with text. So, you know, mail is going to want it all to be kind of inline with text. So if you set your images, your shapes, things like a table, all to inline with text, then everything should work fine. Then you should be able to select all, copy, and then switch back to mail here, and I can paste this all in here, and you can see how it pastes it in here. It converts some things to images. It keeps other things as editable, like for instance, this table here is still editable. This is now an image since mail doesn't handle shapes. But you can play around with it and get you know, different effects, different things you want, see what is compatible between Pages and Mail. If you try to go in Pages to some of the templates they have, they're not going to work at all. Matter of fact, some of the more complex ones, if you paste them in, they're just going to paste in as a full image, which may be fine. Maybe if you want to do that, what you want to do is export as a PDF and send the PDF in an email. But if you're looking for something that uses a template, you can do a few extra bits here by composing in Pages, experimenting, and then pasting into an email message like this one. And then I could save this also as a draft, and then I can move it down from drafts into stationery here. I didn't assign a subject for this one. You can see how the subject I assigned for that one appears here. So subject is a really good way to figure out which template is which in your new stationery folder. Thank you.